Dopamine is released from neurons. It's what we call a neuromodulator. And as a neuromodulator, it changes the activity of the circuits in the brain such that certain circuits are more active than others. And in particular, dopamine creates a heightened state of focus. It tends to contract our visual world, and it tends to make us pay attention to things that are outside and beyond the confines of our skin. It's what we call exteroception. Dopamine also tends to put us in a state of motivation and wanting things outside the confines of our skin. So whether or not we're pursuing something physical in our world, or whether or not we're pursuing information in our outside world, dopamine is largely responsible for our ability and our drive to do that. But dopamine as a neuromodulator is also involved in changing the way that we perceive the world. So as I mentioned earlier, you have all these senses coming in, and you can only perceive some of them because you're only paying attention to some of them. Dopamine, when it's released in our brain, tends to turn on areas of our brain that narrow our visual focus and our auditory focus. So it creates a cone of auditory attention that's very narrow, creates a tunnel of visual attention that's very narrow. Whereas when we have less dopamine, we tend to view the entire world. We tend to see the whole scene that we are in. We tend to hear everything all at once. So as I describe this, hopefully you're already starting to see and understand how having dopamine release can allow a person, whether or not they have ADHD or not, to direct their attention to particular things in their environment. Right? So now what we're doing is we're moving away from attention as this kind of vague, ambiguous term, and we're giving it a neurochemical identity, dopamine, and we are giving it a neural circuit identity. And just to put a little bit of flavor and detail on which neural circuits those are, I wanted to discuss two general types of neural circuits that dopamine tends to enhance. The first one is called the default mode network. The default mode network is the network of brain areas in your brain, in my brain, and in everybody's brain that is active when we're not doing anything, when we're just sitting there idle at rest. The other set of circuit are the task networks, the networks of the brain that make you goal-oriented, or that are at least trying to make you goal-oriented. And those are a completely different set of brain areas. However, the default mode network and these task networks are communicating with one another.